Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and welcome back to this next video. And in this video, I am going to talk about the normal cells versus the cancer cells. When you talk about the human body, so our body constantly produced new cells. And these new cells, they are of two types. One, they are called is the normal cells. By that I mean that these are the cells that are required for the normal physiological functions of our body. What these normal cells do, they follow a typical cycle. These normal cells, they grow, they divide, and they die. And by following this particular cycle, the number of the required cells in the body is maintained, and the normal physiological function of the body is maintained. The other types of the cells, the new cells, they can be produced in the human body. They are known as the cancer cells. Now, these cancer cells, on the other hand, or in comparison to the normal cells, they usually do not follow this particular cycle, that they grow, they divide, and they die. What these cancer cells do, that instead of dying, they multiply and continue to produce other abnormal cells. So if they are not dying, that means that the number of cells in the body that is exceeding the normal limit, and when that is exceeding, that is negatively affecting the human body. Now, these cancer cells, they also invade the other body parts, such as the breast, liver, lungs, and pancreas. And by invading the other organs in the body, they are negatively affecting the functions of those particular organs. And when they invade the other body parts, what they do is that they usually use the blood or the lymphatic system to spread to these other parts of the body. And when they spread to the other parts of the body, then they are going to affect the functions of those particular organs negatively. So let us talk about the differences in the normal cells and the cancer cells in a little bit detail. Now, the first difference between the normal cells and the cancer cell is that the normal cells, they are under the cell cycle control system. When you talk about the cell division, the cell division is usually controlled by two things, or there are two things that are required for the normal cellular division. One that is known as the machinery, and the other one that is known as the control system. So this is not the scope of this video that I go into the detail what they do, but just keep in mind that the control system of the cell cycle that include a variety of the proteins, the important being the cyclin proteins, the CDKs, which are the cell division kinases, or the cyclin dependent kinases, and a protein degrading system, which is known as the UPS, or which is known as the ubiquitin proteasome system. This control system ensures that the number of cell division, that will be only those numbers which are required for the normal physiological functions. So this control system will not allow the abnormal cell division. So these normal cells, when they are under the control system, this means that they will grow, they will divide, and they will die. When you talk about the cancer cells, they are not under the cell cycle control system. What I mean by this is that when you talk about these cancer cells, the control system loses its control, and when the control is lost, these cells, they are going to divide abnormally. The second important difference between the normal cells and the cancer cells is that these normal cells, when they die, they die by the process of the apoptosis, which is a programmed cell death. And when these normal cells, they are removed by this apoptosis, the apoptotic bodies, they are formed, and these apoptotic bodies ensure that the spill of these dying cells, that will not damage the surrounding tissue, because all of the spills or all of the debris or these dying cells, they are removed from the body in the control system by utilizing these apoptotic bodies. When you talk about the cancer cells, they usually follow necrosis, which is not a programmed cell death. And when they follow the necrosis, there is uncontrolled release of the cell material. And when there is uncontrolled release of the cell material, they are going to cause inflammation in the surrounding tissue. and the inflammation is going to negatively affect the surrounding tissue. So this is another major difference between the normal and the cancer cells. Another important difference is that these normal cells, they don't divide after the signal is over. When you talk about the normal cell division, what happens is that there will be a ligand or there would be a signal. That signal is going to bind to its receptor. And when the signal it binds to its receptor, you can see a chemical cascade of the messengers that is activated, and in the end a response is generated. And in this particular case, the response will be the division of the cell. What this means is that if in normal condition, if there is no signal, the receptor is not going to get activated, the cell is not going to divide. But when you talk about these cancer cells, they keep on dividing even if the signal is over, because if the signal it interacts with these receptor, so there is some problem with these receptor, or there are some mutations in these receptor, or there are some mutations in these chemical messengers that are present in the cytoplasm, and they once they are activated for a longer period of time, or they are activated abnormally. And when they are activated abnormally, that is going to lead to the abnormal cell division, and that abnormal cell division is actually the cancer. So I'll continue the discussion in the next video, and I'll tell you more differences between the normal cells and in the cancer cells. So if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and share it with your friends.